be surprised to see me at any time, Norma, dear.
But I'm always glad to see you, Miss Warren. Won't you sit down?
Thank you, dear. Now that you've finished school, Norma, dear, just what are your plans for the future?
Oh, Miss Warren, I'm glad to see you have such an interest in me. Now, as to my plans for the future.
Why, Norma, dear, don't tell me that you haven't any plans.
Oh, yes, I have some plans made, but they're not very definite. I haven't quite decided just what I shall do.
I see. Like most young girls, you want to play around a while before you settle down to business. Now, that's all right, dearie. I'm not going to scold you. But I want you to be different, Norma. You see, I've taken an interest in you. By the way, I had a letter from a friend of mine in Batesburg. Only today. And they want a teacher there. I think you're just the girl for that position. Now, I have the letter with me. I'll let you read it.
Warren, for giving me this opportunity, and I'll answer this letter at once, advising them that I'll take the school, and will let you know what the results are as quickly as I hear from them.
Very well, Norma, dear, you do that. And be a sweet girl, and I wish you lots of luck. And I hope to see you soon.
Thank you. minute. I must hurry.
My daughter sings in the choir. Well, everybody around here knows Mary Austin.
Oh, that's fine. Well, I wish to go to her house.
Well, now, miss, if you don't mind, I'll show you to her house. I know just where she lives, just down the block here. Let me have your bag. I'll take you right.
Well, little girl, I know Mary very well. She used to cook for my family for years. I'd be glad to take her to your house. My car is right over there. Well, what about it?
Thank you, sir. I prefer to walk.
Oh, Miss Mary.
Oh, Mr. Washington.
I know just who you're looking for. She arrived all right and inquired for you, but before I could direct her to your house, up walked Ballinger.
Ballinger?
Old man Ballinger himself.
Oh, my goodness. How did this happen?
Well, it just happened, Miss Mary. You know, he's usually around the station at train time, and he saw this girl get off the train. And as I was saying, before I could direct her to your house, why, he strolled into the picture.
Yes, yes.
And then I strolled out. But before I left, I gave her the signal, and she caught on and refused to get in his car. Now, listen, Miss Mary, you hurry on home, and I'll show you you'll find her there waiting for you all right. I'd like to help you, but I think Ballinger's kind of mad at me. And you know, when Ballinger's mad, he's kind of unhealthy. So you rush on home, and I'm quite sure that you'll find her there, Miss Mary.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Washington, for what you've done.
That's all right, Miss Mary.
And I do hope that you don't get into any trouble with Ballinger about it.
Well, you see, I was going away for a few days anyway, so I guess now is just as good a time to leave as any. Well, so long, and I'm sure you'll find out they're all right, Miss Mary.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Washington. So long.
Bye-bye. I'll see you.
Bye. it isn't anything in particular.
Good evening, lady. There's a young man here that said he would like to get room and board, and,
Why, come right in, Mr. Washington, and bring the gentleman with you.
Oh, thank you very much, Miss Austin. This young man said he wanted a nice place to stay, and I know your house is just the place he wanted, so here he is. Come in, Mr., I forget the name.
Oh, Wright is my name.
Miss Austin, meet, Mr. White.
How do you do,
Glad to meet you, Miss Austin.
And this is Miss Shepherd, Mr. White, who also arrived today.
I'm glad to meet you, Mr. Shepherd.
Well, come on in, folks, and make yourself at home.
Oh, thanks, Miss Austin. Go ahead, Mr. White. Thank you. You know, it's pretty lucky that you found that girl.
I never dreamed of
you. I'll cut the argument. I'm sick of this jumpiness every time a new skirt comes to town. After all, you've been well taken care of. What are you crying about?
Oh, I'm not crying, Jeff Ballinger. I'm just trying to tell you that I'm leaving you. Do you hear? I'm leaving you.
Leave him, but damn, I don't care. You have been leaving for years.
But I mean what I say, Jeff Ballinger. And unless you give me what I'm asking for, I'm liable to forget and begin to talk. Do you get that?
So you're thinking about talking, are you? But I'm thinking you won't be doing so much talking after all, damn you!
And as I was saying, Mr. Throckmorton offered Tump $2.50 a day to pick cotton. But old Tump was kind of lucky, and he had about $10 or $15 in his pocket, and he refused. So Mr. Ballinger tipped the constable off to where Tump was sweating over a big dice game. Well, they arrested Tump and fined him $30 or 60 days, and now Mr. Throckmorton's got Tump picking cotton for nothing.
All very interesting and funny. But I don't quite catch the joke. I'm rather curious and want to understand.
Why, Mr. White, I thought you caught on. Don't you see? It's one of Ballinger's schemes. You see, Throckmorton was Ballinger's agent, and Ballinger was the one that wanted Tump, and the joke is how he got in.
Oh, I understand. And as you say, so Ballinger has him now, working for nothing, eh?
Well, he's supposed to be working out his fine, but he didn't do nothing but engage in a harmless crap game. Why, the charge is ridiculous. And that's why I say that Ballinger is getting his services for nothing.
This man, Ballinger, seems to sort of have his own way around here.
Mr. White, he runs the town, has his own way about everything, does just as he pleases. And if you don't do to please Jeff Ballinger, well, you'd better leave town or make yourself mighty scarce.
I see.
Oh, excuse me, Mr. White, but did you say that you came down here to,
practice research, Mr. Washington? Yes, that's my profession. Research.
Which is something Mr. Washington doesn't understand at all. Do you, Mr. Washington? So we'll just let it go at that. I can tell you what Mr. Washington does understand, however, and that is how to sing.
Oh, hush, Miss Mary.
He has a splendid voice and knows how to use it. So I suggest that we go into the front room where Mr. Washington will entertain us with a song. Won't you, Mr. Washington?
He's all right with me, Miss Mary, if you all can stand it.
No, I can't sing. I'm on that between the apple and the orange. Here's my baritone.
If you want your soul to be, come on along and shout with me. Shout, sister, shout, sister, shout. If the devil's by the hand, that's one thing that he can't stand. Shout, sister, shout, sister, shout. While strolling down by the river, singing a hallelujah song, up jumped the devil before me. Just keep back alone.
Here, honey. Take this. Take this.
Why, good heavens, you're wounded. You've been shot. I'll call a doctor.
No, no. Don't wait. I'm not hurt so bad, maybe. I think you can fix me up. I don't want a doctor. I don't want people to know that.
You know that Jeff Ballinger shot you, eh? Now I can understand, Liza. And I ought to finish you. I know I ought to finish you. You've been a wicked woman. And I ought to take this gun that Jeff Ballinger tried to kill you with and shoot you and go out and tell the whole town that he done it. Oh, they all know about it. They know you're Jeff Ballinger's gal. You've been his gal for years. And I ought to take this gun and shoot the dirty life out of you and tell that he done it. Someday I'm going to kill Ballinger. I'm going to shoot the dirty life out of him just as sure as my name is Wade Washington.
But you're not going to.
What?
Because you ain't got the guts. No, you ain't got the guts. You're scared to say anything, much less do anything. Oh, I admit I've been wicked. And maybe I deserve to die. But my time ain't come yet. No, not yet. But if you'd have been half the man you ought to have been, you'd have never let me become Jeff Ballinger's gal. Oh, I hate you. Damn you. I hate you.
I was wrong. We were both wrong. Oh, Liza, I loved you. Always have loved you. That's the reason I carried on so. Listen, Liza, I'm with you right and I'm with you wrong. You know that. Well, honey, I'd die for you.
Oh. I understand, Wade. And I forgive you. After all, I know you love me. And I guess I don't exactly hate you. But I can only seem to love you and feel it when you beat me. Wade, why don't you take your fist and smack me in the mouth? Go ahead, Wade. Smack me in the mouth with your fist so I can love you.
I couldn't beat you with your fighting and bleeding. I never did want to beat you, Liza. There were times that you acted so dog-fighted on me that I has to beat you, honey. I just has to beat you. But I ain't gonna beat you now. I'm gonna dress your wound and brace your back to help and strength so you'll be well and pretty again. You hear me, Liza?
No.
Yes, I hear you, Wade. I hear you.
Flatter me, Miss Shepherd. But you also interest me a great deal. Indeed, I hardly expected to meet anybody down here or anywhere else like you.
It's kind of you to say such nice things, Mr. White.
It's easy, because I know I speak the truth. You seem to sort of inspire a new confidence in me with regard to a girl. Now, as to my business, I trust you'll appreciate my position when I say that it is confidential. I can't say more just now. And I hope you won't even tell anybody that I've said that much. I know I can trust you.
Of course you can, Mr. White. Why, I'll tell no one of our conversation. In the meantime, if you let me, I'd like to tell you something. Something confidential also.
Yes, by all means, Norma. I mean, Miss Shepherd.
Norma is my name. You may call me that if you wish to. At least it is easy to say.
I'll be glad to, but only if you remember that mine is Alonzo.
Alonzo. Let's make it Lon for short. That is real easy to say.
Fine.
Okay, then it's understood that you're to call me Norma, and I can call you Lon when we're alone. But we'll be a little formal in the presence of others, say for a week. How's that?
Okay. But suppose I should forget and call you Norma at such a time. Would you agree not to be...
angry and scold you? I promise.
Oh, I don't see that I could ever be angry with you, Norma. Or that you could be with me.
This is getting interesting and wonderful. I feel the same way about you.
Isn't it comforting to feel that way? Well, I don't think I ever felt quite this way towards anybody until I met you. I seem to want to put my whole life into your keeping. Tell you everything. Do anything for you. Oh, Norma.
Don't say any more now, Alonzo. Let me finish what I started to.
Oh, yes. Yes, yes. Go on.
Well, it's about this man, Dellinger. I've been informed that he intends calling on me tonight.
To call on you? Why, Norma? I didn't know that you...
No, I never met him formally. But he saw me the day I arrived and spoke to me and offered to drive me to Mrs. Austin's in his car.
And?
Of course I refused him. I didn't like his eyes and the way he looked at me. And will have nothing to do with him. Now, you've heard how he runs his town. And it's especially after every new and strange girl that comes here.
Yes, I understand. And it's a rather strange coincidence. Well, I'm interested in Ballinger more than he has the least idea of. Now he plans to call on you tonight. Okay. Suppose we stroll back towards Mrs. Austin's now. And as we go, I'll try to think of a way to entertain Mr. Ballinger when he calls on you tonight. Let's go.
Thank you.
agent from the Department of Justice, United States Secret Service. I was sent here to observe, investigate, and arrest Jack Ballinger. I can't tell you more now, but I'm looking for the landing when he intrudes himself on you. Now, have no fear, my dear. I'm fully prepared for this visit, and I shall protect you with my life, if necessary.
Oh, Alonzo, how can I ever thank you?
Don't try to now, darling. I shall protect you with my life because I love you, Norma.
Oh, Alonzo, do be careful. If anything should happen to you, I want it to happen to me also.
My angel, my precious darling. Just a moment, Norma. I have an idea. Stay there, and when the would-be boyfriend rings, let him do so two or three times and then call softly. Come in, get me?
Yes, dear.
God bless you, Norma. Quiet now, I hear him. He's coming.
Any of this. Who are you?
Ah, you finally got around to me at last, huh? You made it easy for me, Mr. Ballinger. I'm an agent from the Department of Justice, United States Secret Service. I'll send you to investigate magicians with regard to Fearnish, which it seems you have been practicing freely. And it's tempting to arrest you on those charges. If you don't mind, the car waits. You and I will come to deck. They've got a nice cell waiting for you down there. Let's go. I'll send an undertaker for Mr. Ballinger's buddy outside. I think he got in the way of one of his boss's bullets. Now, tell the precious and wait for me. I'll be back as quickly as I may all get comfortable and safe in deck. So long there. Let's go.
Darling.
Alonzo.
Why, my dear? You look worried. What's the matter?
It's Mrs. Austin. She had to go to New York. Her daughter met with an accident. And I've been here alone ever since you went away. I've been
frightened. About what?
About Ballinger. I've been afraid
that... Oh, calm your fears on that call, my dear. Jeff Ballinger will annoy nobody in Batesburg or anywhere else for a long time. He's as safe in jail in Jackson as iron bars can make him.
Oh, Alonzo, I'm so glad to hear that. But I've been strangely worried and frightened with Alston since Alston left. And, too, the school board has declared opening for another 3 months because of an empty treasury. And I don't know what to do.
That all settles you, my precious. You're going to New York with me. Well, in 3 months, if you trust me, we'll be married. Oh, Norma, kiss me.
Oh, Alonzo, you're so fine. And your words have made me very happy. Why, I think you're the most wonderful man in the whole world. And I've always trusted you, dear.
My angel. Now, pack as quickly as you can, my dearest. And I'll be ready to take you away from Batesburg and out of the state of Mississippi for good. You're going to New York with me, my baby. Home to Harlem and all that goes with it. Get me, honey?
Yes, Alonzo, I get you. Home to Harlem. But I've never been to Harlem or New York, dear. Though I've always wanted to go. They say you'll love it, Harlem. After you've been there a while. No end to theaters and...
And nightclubs with good singing and dancing until the wee hours of the morning. We're going to hurry to New York, my baby. Harlem and a good time. Oh, kiss me again, sweetheart.
Thank you.
morning, Miss Austin. Have you got your numbers ready? And how much is your plane this morning?
I beg your pardon, sir, but I am not Mrs. Austin, and I do not play the numbers. Good day.
Well, smack my mouth. Hello, darling.
Was. Can't manage this woman. Cuban. Gomez, a number banker.
I see. She's made quite a lot of money, and there's no record of where he has filed any returns. I shouldn't be surprised to hear of his arrest any day.
Now, the people who play with him and win, does he pay them?
He has to, as long as he stays in business. It's dangerous not to pay off. But I don't trust Gomez. He has a funny eye. Never looks straight at you. Sort of furtive. In fact, always furtive. Shall we? You ought to play it heavy. You ought to play all you got on it.
Oh, I dare not. These numbers have all but ruined me. They cut every cent I make. I'm behind in everything. I'm head over heels in debt. And my sister, my poor sister, is dying in the hospital for want of cash. They say she must have an operation to live. And I promised to show good faith by paying $10 a week, but I paid $50. Then they will operate. And I can pay the other in 2 years. $500. Oh, I can't play tonight. I can't.
But you dreamed of something, Miss Mary. That's a message from above. That's a message from on high. The Lord intends for you to win. You're a Christian woman, Miss Mary. But you've just been in bad luck. Don't you see, if you play this number, play it heavy, you're liable to win. And then you'll be out the bell. Think of it. $20 spring on it will give you $11,000. $11,000 cold.
Oh, please, I could never win that much money. Never.
Yeah. It's in the making, Miss Mary. I'm gonna play it myself. Something tell me that number's coming out. It's coming tomorrow. Go ahead and play it, Miss Mary. Go ahead. Let me write you up. That kind of means a bit. They take a chance when they have a hunch. And the hunch comes true. All the big men, all the rich men. Go on, Miss Mary. Let me write you up for $20, and you'll be rich this time tomorrow.
Oh, stop it. Why do you tempt me? I'm going to take this money to the hospital and save my sister's life. I've gambled every dollar I've earned on dream numbers, hunches, tips. On top of which, I'm sinned terribly. And it isn't right. You ought to be trying to persuade a poor, helpless woman like me. Now go! Leave me, please!
That number's coming out tomorrow, do you hear? And when you win 11 grand, you won't have to worry no more, Miss Mary. You can pay for the operation, buy your home, and be in the gutter the rest of your life. Go ahead, Miss Mary. Please go ahead and pray.
This one. But never again. If I lose, I won't be fit to live. And I'm going to kill myself. I'm going to end it all.
¿Qué es esto? $20. Tonto. Too many times I've told you never take more than $1 on one number straight. You know about the brain? Come someday, somebody make a hit on a big play like this and wreck on me. Kids up. Now's it too late to place any of these 20 with Arthur Banker. And who's can tell which number he's come today?
I won't come out, boss. It's only one chance in 1,000. And it'll never come out today.
No me digas más de eso. This one chance in thousands. He's a breaker, plenty banker. I got the meat fixed pretty good now. And I no pay big money to nobody. Because I'm thinking taking trip.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah! Going home, outside. Scram!
For you now.
Now come on, Gomez, let's back up.
Cause you ain't fooling me. You're beating it with all the dough, and I know it. Well, if you're leaving me behind, you're leaving some of the dough with me. Get that and get it right. Give me one of those things.
That's no good either. You got to me wrong.
Don't try to handle that stuff, old man. I know you, and I know you're beating it. So give me one of those bags and be quick about it.
All right, Carina, whatever you say. Gomez, he like you. You say give you money, he give money. You say give you bag, he give you bag. But before...
to be the only ones of our group aboard.
I was thinking of that when I saw you.
Quite a coincidence. I hope it can be made a pleasant one.
Why not?
Hope care is made.
What are you bound for?
Vienna. And you?
Paris.
I'm passing through Paris. I'm getting off at Cherbourg.
Fine. What's your line?
Pleasure. And yours?
Same. Where are you from?
Frisco. And you?
Chicago.
Ha! Huh. The girl from Chicago, huh? Well, I don't see why we can't start having that good time right away. You certainly not hard to look at.
And you don't break my eyes at all.
It's about lunchtime. Suppose you talk my appetite with something to drink. How's that?
Okay with me.
Let's go. Well, has a little girl from Chicago ever been to Mississippi?
Not much. Just a short time.
Where about?
Oh, Vicksburg, Natchez, and...
Vicksburg?
Yes, for a week or two.
So was I. Did you happen to meet Miss Mary Austin there?
I don't think so.
You know, I'm beginning to like you.
Oh, stop your kidding.
Honest. Let's have a drink to a good time. What do you say?
Okay with me.
Come on, have a drink.
Gee, I like you. And you can have anything I've got.
That's great, honey. But see you, pretty.
Think so?
Uh-huh.
Well, as I said, you look good to me. And any old time you like, you can park your chewing gum on my instep. In other words, you can start being my sugar daddy right now.
Okay with me.
Kiss me, honey. Your kisses are sweet.
They can be sweeter if you'll tell me more about yourself. See, when you begin to like somebody, you want to know just...
Where they've been all your life.
Now, that's it. Now, where have you been all my life?
Sin never pays. I was taught all my life that it didn't. Now I'm in jail, and I'm going to die, deep in sin.
No, no, it isn't so. You haven't sinned, and they can't kill you for what you didn't do. Oh, it won't be, it can't be.
It is God's punishment. I was doomed the day I started to sin.
Working on your case, and he won't fail us. So brace up, dear. Be patient and pray.
Well, that's the story of poor Mary Austin. And just think of it. In a few days, she must go to the chair.
Ah, but she didn't do it. I know she didn't. Well, I was there when she come, and...
And what?
Oh, come on, honey. Let's forget about Mary Austin and everybody else. Just you and me. Come on. Kiss me. Love me some more.
Yes, and what?
Nothing, nothing. I don't know nothing about it.
Well, there was something. You said she didn't do it. Well, if you were there, you ought to know. You're...
Well, I wasn't there, and I don't know nothing about it.
place you under arrest for the murder of Maximo Gomez.
Why, you... Take him off. Get him off. Why, you dirty snitch. I could kill you just like I did.
Gomez, eh? Well, to kill Gomez is one thing. But to let poor innocent Mary Austin pay with her life for what you've done is another.
I don't care no more about Mary Austin than I do about you, you skunk. And I'm gonna kill you if it's the last thing I do on this earth.
Okay, Chief, come in.
Here.